Mr. Georgiadis, thank you very much for a very insightful presentation, and congratulations for all the work you've done. I would kindly ask Mr. Phivos Stasopoulos to take the podium. I'd like to thank Hellenic Bank for being the main sponsor of this event. Your help has been very critical in our ability to organize it, so thank you very much. And he is going to guide us through the progress in the banking sector.
Thank you.
And you have the clock down there. Oh, you have the clock down there to find yourself.
And the.
And we have a presentation, though.
Thank you very much. Good morning to everybody. Unavoidably, there may be some repetition in certain aspects, especially regarding the Cyprus economy from what the minister has just went through. In Cyprus, we feel that we are blessed. We are blessed because we live in a beautiful island. We are blessed because we have beautiful sandy beaches, lovely forests, blessed because we have exceptional climate and a superb location. Recently, however, we also feel that we have been truly blessed because we have lived and we have seen it all. Bail-in, bail-out, banks going into resolution, banks closing down, debt service platforms, sale of loans, everything. So how did we really manage to get here? We had accumulated imbalances resulting from large deposits inflows into the two major banks in Cyprus. Then we had the banks having excessive exposures to the Greek economy, both from loan operations as well as from investments in Greek government bonds. Thirdly, we have an excessive credit expansion abroad, outside Cyprus, and especially in jurisdictions not really relevant to the Cyprus economy, Romania, Serbia, Ukraine, Russia. Thirdly, we had a rapid fiscal deterioration and reduced economic activity, resulting in a state unable to support the ailing banking sector. And last but not least, we had a very weak prudential supervision. So, following the events of the Eurogroup in 2013, the Greek operations of the banks, including Hellenic Bank, were sold to Bank of Piraeus in an effort to ring-fence the Cyprus economy from Greece. Subsequently, the two main banks were subject to a restructuring by means of a resolution, and uninsured depositors were subject to a bail-in. The capital required for the two main Cypriot banks in order to be adequately capitalized exceeded 50% of the Cypriot GDP and was covered exclusively from contributions of uninsured depositors. Then the third largest bank at the time, the Co-op, was bailed out from funds borrowed from Troika. On the road to recovery, and following the events described earlier, an economic adjustment program was needed to recapitalize the banks and to provide financing for the government. The program addressed short-term and medium-term financial, fiscal, and structural challenges with measures under three pillars. First pillar, public finances. As the minister said, fiscal consolidation for correcting the excessive general government deficit. Second pillar, the banking sector, where enhanced supervision, greater liquidity and recapitalization of the banks was needed to rebuild confidence. And thirdly, structural measures aimed at enhancing competitiveness and returning to a sustainable and balanced growth path. Cyprus has achieved an impressive turnaround, and the economic recovery gathered pace in 2017, with real GDP increasing by 4.2%, the best growth performance for almost a decade. While in crisis, not everything went wrong. Thank God we have managed to see the crisis as an opportunity as well. Certain challenges, though, still remained. The high level of NPEs, the high ratio of public debt to GDP, and the implementation of certain structural reforms. The restoration of our credibility was our top priority through the strict adherence to the economic adjustment program. The program has delivered an impressive turnaround, and during the last 3 years, the Cyprus economy has been the fastest growing economy in Europe. The successful completion of the program, the continuous credit rating upgrades, the successful sovereign bond issues have marked an end to a prolonged uncertainty and have revived confidence. The banking system is now on a much more solid footing, and effective handling of NPEs is opening space for more and productive lending. The introduction of the structural reforms is the beginning of an improvement in the efficiency, productivity, and competitiveness of the economy. The economy is returning to the levels that were observed in 2008. The recovery phase has passed, and the economy is settling into its growth phase. What is encouraging, though, for the new growth phase is the fact that it has not been driven by public spending, and it has not been funded from unsustainable credit fuel consumption, as used to be the case in the past. While consumption continues to be a very key recovery driver, investment demand has also rebounded, as shown on this graph. What are the real contributors to this growth? From a sectoral point of view, growth was supported by resilient export performance in the services industries, tourism, wholesale and retail, as well as professional services. Overall, what this graph indicates is the fact that the recovery of the Cypriot economy has been broad-based and not dependent on one or two sectors only. Moving on to the Cyprus banking system, a more consolidated, more recapitalized, and stronger banking system. The banking system has gone through a reformation phase and is now in a strengthened capital position. Foreign exposures have been eliminated, and domestic operations now form the main focus of activity. The size of the banking sector has shrunk to a moderate 3.5 times of the GDP and is now close to the EU average. Systemic banks are well above the capital thresholds specified by the European Central Bank. We are experiencing an increased pace of sustainable restructurings, stabilization of deposits, normalization of lending and deposit rates, improved sentiment from international customers, strengthened financial supervision, strong presence of international institutional investments from Europe and the US, including supranational institutions like the European Bank of Regional Development. The most challenging side effect of the economic crisis is the high level of non-performing loans, but we now have the legislations in place, we have all the tools necessary, the right tax incentives, and the appetite to do all the right things in this field. The level of non-performing exposures is declining, but remains very high. So, while the challenge of the handling of the NPEs is ahead of us, the challenge has created two major opportunities: the setup of NPE servicing platforms and the sale of loan portfolios. So how did we react at Hellenic Bank regarding the NPE challenges? We were the first bank in Cyprus to enter a partnership with a specialized international company, APS, for the efficient servicing of our NPEs and our REOs. apart from the expertise gained that allowed us to focus our resources on the growth track of our good book. A secondary market for NPEs has gradually emerged, providing an alternative way of managing credit and market risk. An NPE market is expected to attract a wider range of institutional investors and help expand another source of capital. In June 18, Hellenic Bank was the first bank to enter an agreement for the sale of non-performing portfolios of around 140 million and tested the waters effectively for a larger disposal. Despite the consolidation observed in the banking system in Cyprus during the last 4 or 5 years, compared to the euro area, the population per credit institution, per branch, and per bank employee in Cyprus remain much lower than the euro area average. These statistics suggest that there is an overriding need to significantly reduce the number of banking institutions, the number of branches, and the number of bank employees in order to make our banks more competitive. This becomes unavoidable as we embrace digital technology. Within the framework of NPE reduction and bank consolidation, very recently Hellenic Bank has acquired certain assets and liabilities from the Cyprus Cooperative Bank in the tune of approximately 10 billion. The move provides attractive strategic, commercial, and financial advantages to the bank, as from day one, the transaction will enable value creation through enlargement and through synergies. The attractive structure of the transaction will lead to a significant reduction of the bank's strategic and business risks, as well as to the risks arising from the balance sheet with the high ratio of NPEs, as the transaction will effectively dilute our NPEs to less than half of their existing level. In addition, the bank's reliance on income arising from international activities will also be reduced due to the new sources of income deriving from the transaction. However, there is scope for further consolidation given that the banking system in Cyprus is still composed by 11 credit institutions for an island with a population of under 1 million. I truly consider Cyprus as being a hotspot for foreign direct investment. Why should someone invest in Cyprus? Cyprus is a small, open, service-driven dynamic economy, full member of the European Union since 2004, at the crossroads of Europe, Asia, and Africa. Legal framework based on the English legal system, one of the most attractive, transparent, and simple tax systems in Europe, English being the business language, infrastructure well matched to the needs of business people, and last but not least, an economy at a stable expansion stage. Which are the areas that we consider as being attractive areas for investment? Several large-scale development projects, such as luxury resorts, marinas, hotels, tourist resorts, and golf courses, are already underway, most of them with the use of significant level of foreign investment. The financing of infrastructure projects in the oil and gas industry are areas of interest. Hospitality is gaining momentum, especially with the creation of the first integrated casino resort in Europe, a landmark attraction to a large extent funded by foreign investment as well. Shipping is another industry which offers great opportunities given the banks and given the country's strategic location, along with an attractive legislative and operational shipping infrastructure. The discovery of hydrocarbons in Cyprus has created new and exciting prospects for Cyprus to become an energy hub in the Eastern Mediterranean. Recent developments have attracted worldwide interest and significant investments from leading international energy giants, as well as companies serving this industry. Recent cooperation agreements with neighboring countries give further potential to this area. Industry sectors which are ripe for investment are also the sectors of renewable energy, the sectors of education, the healthcare sectors, and the professional services sectors. Ladies and gentlemen, during the last 15 minutes, I hope to have managed to convey to you the past, the present, and the future of the Cyprus economy and its banking sectors and the resulting investment opportunities. Thank you for your attention.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Costas Kellas, CEO of Objecutive INC and former president of the Hellenic American Bank Association. I'm very pleased to welcome you all to the second Capital Link Invest in Cyprus Forum. Both myself and Nicholas Nicolaou, here at sitting over there, we always felt that all these events should be done through Capital Link. Thank you, Nicholas, for Cyprus has made remarkable progress restructuring the banking and financial services sector. Cyprus has reaffirmed and reinforced its position as a financial and fund management hub. Cyprus offers political stability, European Union membership status, and a transparent legal and tax system coupled with an efficient support services infrastructure system. Today's event features government and business leaders who will update us on the progress and opportunities in finance, energy, and shipping. I would very much like to thank Mr. Frank Miller, senior partner of Sherman Sterling, for his sponsorship today. And I would like to kindly ask him to come to the podium to moderate our next session. Thank you.